this fan base. A great crowd on hand to battle the raindrops at Nissan Stadium in Nashville. This crowd here fired up for football as a moment ago their Titans were introduced. This should be a good one as the Titans get set to match up with the Kansas City Chiefs. And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. Right out of the gate, we're going to get a delay. Back where we started as they come up on a first and 10. On play action, it's Mahomes. He finds Smith out of the backfield. Going to be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Mahomes going to throw. He'll drop this one off at ETN. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40.
Well, he was a busy man out of the backfield a week ago. They got the ball early and often. I have no doubt in my mind that he'll be a big part of the game plan here as well.
On first down, Mahomes eluding the pressure right. He'll get this off to ETN. And he'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. 12 yards on back-to-back plays there, and that's another first down.
First down. First and 10 at the 30-yard line.
And again, it's Mahomes. This is Smith to the ground. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here. And now they're set up with a first and goal.
A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door, first and goal. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
No sense risking anything there on first down. Even though he's still in the pocket, he had a receiver out to his side, so he'll just put that in a spot where the only people who could make a play on it are the trainers and the coaches. Well done.
Kill, kill, kill. Turn up. Kill, kill, kill. Turn up. Check 31. Check 31. Take motion, motion, motion.
On second down, a run with ETN. And a short pickup there down to about the 9. Only a yard there, and that'll bring us to third and goal. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, and now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this four down territory? Might he go for it?
Here's Mahomes, third and goal. He'll drop that underneath DTN, and he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. They do get 8 out of the pitch and catch. However, it's 4th down.
Well, there certainly was a lot going on that play. Every option in the end zone covered. No place to go with the ball. Had to swing it out to the back. A good job running and getting him tackled in the open field.
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on 4th. Now Mahomes. And it's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tennessee. Mo Alie-Cox, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Titans take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. The point after through the raindrops, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Down run with Jacobs going to be well read defensively as they'll stop him for a loss of a couple. This defense for the Titans, they were terrific last week in the victory over Buffalo.
And that's not the half of it. They forced 7 turnovers in that game, and I know we always talk about turnovers coming in bunches once you force the first one, but 7? That seems almost impossible, but we watched it happen.
Second down, Jacobs once more. And a nice run past the 30-yard line there.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Tannehill. Open man is Jacob Hollister. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
And already down 7-0 after the touchdown a minute ago. So a 3-and-out here would not be ideal for them. Nice job finding his receiver there. And they get the first down.
Here's Jacobs on 1st and 10. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. 2nd down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. On the handoff, this is Jacobs. Give him 3 on the run there. Now they're looking at a 3rd and about 5.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Comes Jacobs, and he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like he'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. It's a pickup of 4, but they're still a yard short here with 4th down forthcoming. The Chiefs with the football as we start the 2nd quarter. on fourth down, ready to punt, Michael Dixon. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. And it's out of bounds. Now we'll see what the side judge says. He says out at the 8-yard line.
Let's go old school there. That's absolutely a great coffin corner punt. Someone's put some time in working on that, hasn't it?
Seems like every year these guys get better and better. It's amazing how they can command that football through the air.
Yeah, they used to actually practice with hula hoops where they place them and try and put them there. Now a lot of guys use barrels on the sidelines to try and put the football in one.
Play action. Now it's Mahomes. And he's going to go down. Back at his own 5-yard line. It's a sack. DJ Jones able to record his 5th sack of the season. Second and 14. Back near his goal line. Here's Mahomes. That's complete to Tony. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. A big play there on the catch and run.
As a general manager, you're counting on your first and second round draft picks to have a big time impact on your team. But where you make your bones, rounds 3 through 7. If you can find a few diamonds in the rough there, develop them, then you've got something going. And we're seeing one right here.
Yeah, plays like that lead me to believe that they found a diamond in the rough.
There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. A nice job there, Charles. They picked up the blitz, were able to complete the pass.
That had the total feel of a quarterback in control. Red blitz, got him into the right protection scheme, so he doesn't get hit back there. He's got a chance to step up with supreme confidence and deliver it downfield for a nice completion.
Mahomes firing complete. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. A big connection on that one. 30 yards.
There's no doubt in my mind that not many guys in this league have had the impact that he's had here in the first half of the season. He's been a big play guy from the word go and continues to be one with another one right there. He's coming. Double up,
double up. He's coming, double up. Mahomes taps this forward. It's a jet sweep. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. This defense not fooled one bit on that touch pass.
And this has become one of those kind of in vogue plays, you know, kind of like the shuffle pass was a few years ago. This one never got off the ground, but you understand why a lot of...
And he's going to be dropped back at the 15-yard line. Adafe Owe, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. They need to reverse the trend. The last two plays have gone backwards. Now it's 3rd and goal. Throwing now is Mahomes. Quick slant here to Smith. They are able to get 9 yards out of that, but now it's 4th down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
The kick by Bass is good. And the lead moves to 10-0. So that one on target, and it adds to this first half lead.
And maybe we're too early to worry too much about 1-score lead, 2-score lead, etc. But this is where you kind of start banking those points that come in helpful later on.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. It hasn't gone particularly well for them. That's obvious. In these conditions, no points so far. They've got to get that offense on track. The question, how do they do it?
It is the age-old question, isn't it? And to me, finding a way to make sure your playmakers touch the ball without it being too exotic. Meaning you don't have to go deep down the field. Maybe hit them on the short passes on the perimeter. make sure you just turn around and hand it to your best runner and get out of the way. Don't cause any extra stress on your offense.
On second and 11 now, Tannehill flush to his right. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Tannehill escaping the pressure right, and this one is incomplete.
That looks like it's going to be two empty possessions now to start this football game. I think they're going to have to sit down and talk about what worked for them last week in their win. Sometimes you over game plan, overthink things, get back to what works.
Oh, and what a play on special teams here. This is going to be down inside the five, all the way down at the 2-yard line.
And he's got to be fired up about that effort. I don't think he could have walked down and placed it any better than where he ended up putting the football. That was excellent.
Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put six on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material.
They'll start on the ground, ETN. And he was very fortunate there to get out of his end zone. He maybe got back to the 2-yard line. It's the Pro Bowler Jamie Collins that makes the stop. Now a second timeout called for by the defense as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Second and 10. In his own end zone, it's Mahomes. He'll get this out to the flat for ETN. And he's able to get this one up to the 8-yard line this time. 5 yards. Now it's third and five.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And now here's a deep shot that's complete. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. Mahomes now on first down. And that's complete. ETN out of the backfield. And he goes out of bounds, it looks like right at the 50. And that's good for a gain of 6, and it'll be a second down. From midfield, here's Mahomes. He'll find ETN out of the backfield. And tackled down after a gain of 3, leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down. They'll run with ETN and trying to shake free, but ETN cannot. The defense will stop him short. Now Tennessee going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. Mike Vrabel saw him on the sideline. He didn't even hesitate. They will go for it on fourth. Looking to throw is Mahomes. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Now the Titans will use their third and final timeout as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. Mahomes now on first down. Gonna throw deep for the end zone. Got a man, and it's taken in for a Titans touchdown. Jeff Smith, as the first half is winding down, and the Titans will extend their lead here just before halftime. An extra point by Bass, up and good, and that makes our score 17-0. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive, as they'll take over with just 13 seconds to go before the break. They'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. Now a signal and a timeout call, as it comes with 9 seconds to go in this first half of play. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And he'll just keep two hands on the football as he'll be taken down after a short pickup. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. All right, Coach, thank you very much as we welcome you back for quarter number 3. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them. Tannehill rolling, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Jayon Brown drops him for a loss of 12, and it also brings up fourth down. On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. That's returnable now for Smith, and able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. 62 yards on the punt that time. Wow. And it'll be Titan football. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing? And a big loss here as he's taken down. Now this one from about two counties over after the sack. They come up on a second and very long. The throw for Tony is intercepted. Picked off by the corner, Bradley Roby. And that will set him up in excellent shape. First and goal at the 9-yard line. Suddenly it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. Here's Jacobs. And a nice pick up there. He gets about 5 down to the 4-yard line.
So that run gets him about halfway home.
Yeah, it's now second and goal. The end zone beckons. It looms. They can do whatever they want. Full playbook. Run it again, or they can go play action and try and put it in that way.
Jacobs again. And this time he'll run into a wall right at the 4-yard line. Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. Here's Tannehill. Dancing to his left. And that's going to be knocked away in the end zone. It's incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they've brought the heat. And if he flushes out, they're fine with that. And they force another incompletion.
They figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter as he'll go for it on fourth down. They go with Jacobs, and he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Josh Jacobs, his ninth touchdown of the season, and the Chiefs use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six. Extra point from McManus is good, and the lead is trimmed down to 10. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds, so really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at their own 42. Mahomes going to throw. He'll drop this one off with ETN. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
I know it was a gain, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there, because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of a play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting it to your guy out of the backfield. You're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held him to an okay game.
And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Throwing on first down is Mahomes. And he's out of bounds, almost gets to the 10.
He's starting to fall into the category of not fair, because when he's on target throwing the ball, he's dangerous. But when you add in his ability to make plays with his feet, almost impossible.
Yeah, exactly. They've had trouble stopping him in the secondary. This time they've got the great coverage. Oh, he can run too. On first and 10, here's Mahomes. And he's not able to get away. Sacked back at the 22. Micah Parsons in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. From the gun, it's Mahomes. Left sideline, a dive, and it looks like he's got it. And it's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tennessee. Jeff Smith with his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And the Titans are going to add on to their lead. Extra point hung the upright a bit, but he gets it to go. And that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17.
Chiefs take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
Jalen Smith, the NFC's leading tackler in 2020, there on the stop defensively. Now it's second and nine. Now Tannehill. And a first hookup with his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski. And they work this well upfield across the 45. So both teams trade touchdowns in the third as we're through three quarters of play. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Tannehill on first down. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Here's Tannehill. Looking for Gronkowski, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Jalen Smith. And the Titans are going to take over here up near the 40. Another solid game-changing play for this defense with the interception. At this point, though, I don't know that it's game-changing. I mean, they've got this one in firm control.
And you always hear about, you know, those stories about someone left their game plan behind and maybe you benefit from it. I'm not going to say that that happened, but they certainly have appeared on defense to be a step ahead this entire game. Guys are always in the right spot in order to make a play.
The offense has had its moments, too. So after the INT, here's Mahomes. And that'll be caught by Tony. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Well, normally you might say start running the football. You've got the lead here in the fourth quarter, but the way that they've passed it with such success, I don't know, maybe keep throwing it.
Yeah, I think you brought up something that goes against conventional wisdom, right? In this stage of the game, you would think you would switch to a running attack, but you're exactly right. They've thrown it so well throughout the game, and trusting this quarterback, I think you continue to do so.
Now he dumps this off over the middle, and they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. The passing game continues to be their friend. Even with a stable lead here in the fourth, Charles, they're going back to that well.
Yeah, with their overall philosophy, you know that they trust their quarterback. He's been able to throw it well. They continue to throw these safe passes. Who can blame them?
On first down, Mahomes. And he's taken down, a Chiefs sack. Now then, after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. Here's Mahomes to throw. Under pressure, and they got to him again. Gonna need better protection here. Third and long following the sack for Mahomes and company. They'll drop to throw. Now that's into the hands of Mo Alie-Cox, the tight end. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. And I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah, and being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half. Mahomes throwing on fourth. Airing it out, looking for Ridley. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there.
A big play that time through the air. 34 yards.
No let up in this passing game. They've been a well-oiled machine throughout. And I actually saw a few guys on the sidelines at the end of the third quarter doing the old hold up four fingers college sign, meaning the fourth quarter is ours. And they certainly weren't kidding.
Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes. Buying time to his left. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Smith. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Oh. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. Interesting, Mahomes wants to throw it. Got a man, and it's taken in for a Titans touchdown. Jeff Smith there to make the grab. And the Titans are looking to make it two straight as they add on to this fourth quarter lead. Extra point by Bass, up and good. And the lead is now 24. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away.
The Chiefs take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And their four-game win streak very much in jeopardy as they go to work here late with a first and 10. Going to Woods, but that pass is intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Jalen Smith. And he will take this down to the 10-yard line. All smiles and high fives on that defensive sideline. That interception will cap off what was truly a tremendous performance.
Yeah, if you can hold a team to 7 points in the NFL, that's the kind of day that you feel really good about. Now, I do know a few guys are going to think to themselves, held him to 7. If he'd made one more play, could have had our shutout.
Now, here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete. The incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise they're throwing here late?
Ordinarily, yes, because you would think enough is enough. They've got plenty of lead, but I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense is going to crowd the line of scrimmage. If you just hand it off inside, you're getting your running back popped a lot as well. Sometimes the defense dictates it. If they're going to crowd it, you may have no other choice but to throw it downfield.
And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. The catch good for 6 yards, but now it's third and goal. Now here's Mahomes. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the 4-yard line. The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And they're going to go for this thing. They're not going to leave anything to chance. They're going to roll the dice on fourth and goal. They'll go for it. It's Mahomes. And give him another 6. It's caught for a touchdown, and the blowout continues.
Well, there's just about a minute left in this game, and they're still taking it into the end zone, and you know they could have taken a knee there, but they decided to play this one all the way out, and I think their philosophy is, we're going to give you everything we've got. If we just go ahead and take a knee now, we're actually showing you disrespect that way, like taking pity on you. They're not about to do that to their opponent.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now. And if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments.
yards of this one.
And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's third down. They come up now third and five following the incomplete pass. Now Tannehill. Throwing left side. He's got Gronk complete. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They go ahead and mark it in the win column. But as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them, gets big yardage, and puts points on the board. They have pride, too, on that side of the ball.
On first down, it's Tannehill. Forced out to his left. Wide open, Gronkowski. And down to the 20, he'll go before heading out of bounds. It's a big play there for the Chiefs. Defensively, I know they have the comfortable lead here in the fourth, but they do not want to give up big plays like that.
They want to finish strong. So oftentimes in this situation, you tighten up underneath in your coverage and you bring your safeties back. They can pick up anything that leaks through. But in the meantime, upfield, you're making plays on the football.
That catch good for only a couple.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting.
And that is caught. Well, they're going to see this one at the end. They get a score, but pretty much an exercise in futility right now. Still down big. McManus's point after is good. And the lead is down to 24. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And Smith not going to bring it out, so it's a touchback. The defense can stop it twice more as they take a knee here. So this one, a Tennessee Titan victory. And they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half that put this one on ice.
So you get the sense that whatever was said at halftime obviously hit home. I think it's a little bit more than that, though. Obviously, there are words that are said, and hey, come on, guys, we have to play better. But sometimes it's just sharpening your execution, sharpening your focus, and maybe doing the things you practiced all week without major adjustments, just doing them better.
They talking about making industry music. They want me to count to y'all, but ain't gonna count to y'all, cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. Wonder how he felt watching his dog cast the ball. I had to tell my YG stop. He don't like to pass the ball. That shit, he talking big hit. I was kicking in houses for it. Got two different tickets.
Jones Shorty. season, no, it might just be my last. People view everything differently, you touching on the back. What you say is good intentions, it's for clout and hitters, man. You can never be a son to carry, got away. I'm putting at you, coming at you, Papa, trying to change you. I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging. Moving careful every day is exactly how I play this. Not looking for number one, but that's exactly how I play. I got choices. Keep getting the love from my state. What do I do to keep the money coming in? What do I do? Writing it till I need another pen. Gotta make the right decision. No, it might just be my last. People view everything differently when you touching on the back. What you see is good intentions. It's for clout and hitters, man. You can never be a subject. You carry, gotta wear a mask. They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, Papa, trying to change you. I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging. Moving carefully. How I'm paid. Feel like Jesse Owens, cause I'm taking off with the race. Put the metal to his mouth, retain his tongue, hold the brace. But I'm all about the beast until the sucker hit a make. Oh man, eat man, your performance kinda shaky. I'm prepared for the fame, I like that cops, I'm really like me. But I'd be lying if I said I didn't cry at least once a week. Cause I'm so blessed with no stress, all the way taking off of me. Head in the clouds and I smile like no grandma watching. I'm loving all these cameras in my face. I never knew that I would get the love from my state. Stay with the blue, always keep the money coming in. Ain't nothing new, writing it till I need another pen. Gotta make the right decision, no, it might just be my last. People view everything differently when you touching on the back. What you see is good intentions, it's for clout and hitters, man. You can never be a subject, you carry, gotta wear a mask. They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, Papa, trying to change you. I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging. Moving careful every day is exactly how I play this. Not looking for number one, but that's exactly how I'm pacing.
What up, man?
So I'm back with my brother and together.
Stunner, I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running, made it to the
the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shot up to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. Why after why we ain't never got herself made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Starting like the number one stunner. She curved me back then, came back, so I swung her. I ain't going out like no sucker. Had to let it burn like Usher. Gave a rush for an hour.